Does your document require independent page numbering for different sections? Say, no page number for the title page, Roman numerals for the table of contents and other introductory material, and Arabic numerals for everything after? I'll show you the secret to getting those sections to number independently coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Savadra of Legal Office Guru, your resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And if you're working on an appellate brief or any other document that requires independently numbered sections, I'm here to show you how it's done. I'll warn you, it's going to seem complicated, but once you understand the underlying logic Word uses to accomplish it, this will be a trick you'll have in your back pocket for all sorts of complex documents. Let's get started. The main concept you've got to get your head wrapped around is that for each independently numbered section of your brief, you've got to have two or more independent sections. To create those, you need to insert what Word calls a section break. It's sort of like a page break, but with special properties. So in this example, the cover page has no page number. But the pages in the preliminary section, containing your table of contents, etc., does have page numbers. So you'd need a section break between that cover page and the first page of your preliminary section to create two independent sections that can number independently. The same is true of the break between the preliminaries and the brief proper. Insert a section break so you can then start numbering your brief proper with Arabic numerals. But once you insert your section breaks, you still have to ensure your sections are independent. By default, sections are linked so that the headers, footers, and other formatting information gets repeated. That comes in handy in some situations, but in this one, not so much. Before we insert a page number in any page footer, we have to both insert the section breaks and break the links between each section to ensure each section's page numbering is truly independent. I'm going to keep it simple here and demonstrate this in a blank document. First, let's insert the section break. I'm going to go up to the Layout tab. I'm in version 2019. In some earlier versions, this is called the Page Layout tab. And in the Page Setup command group under Breaks, I'm going to insert Next Page Section Break. And I'll scroll back up and show you what a section break looks like here. This is going to start a new section on a new page. Now I have two sections in my blank document. Section 1 is page 1, and section 2 is page 2. As I showed you before, I'm going to leave page numbering off the first page because that will eventually be my unnumbered cover page. But for section 2, I'm going to want to start the page numbering with a lowercase Roman numeral I. I'm going to double-click into the footer section, and you'll notice on the left it identifies this as the footer for section 2. But over here on the right it says same as previous. What that does is it carries over anything from section 1's footer over into section 2. We don't want that. To break that link, we're going to go into the header and footer tools, which popped up as soon as I double-clicked into the footer. You'll notice that Link to Previous is enabled. You can tell that because it's a bit darker. That's the link we want to break. So I'll just click on that, and that will toggle that setting off. I'm also going to make sure that the Different First Page box is unchecked because we want all the pages of this section to have the same footer formatting. Now that I've made these two sections completely independent, I can put my page number in. While I could go over to the Insert tab to do this, I can also stay right here in Header and Footer Tools. All the way over on the left, I'm going to click Page Number and choose Current Position, Plain Number. I tend to prefer that over using Top of Page or Bottom of Page, because inserting a page number using one of those methods tends to put the page number in a text box, which can sometimes interfere with other elements in the header or footer, such as document management system stamps. So now I've placed my page number on the page, but it's the wrong number, should be 1, and the wrong kind of number, should be Roman rather than Arabic. So I right-click on the number and choose Format Page Numbers. Here I can start the numbering over at 1, and I can change the number format from Arabic to lowercase Roman numerals. Then I can go up to Header and Footer Tools, the Design tab, and close the footer. Now let's create Section 3. Again, I go to the Layout tab, choose Breaks, and click Next Page Section Break. It's the same set of steps. Double-click into the footer. Break the link between Section 2 and Section 3 by toggling off Link to Previous, and then right-click on the page number, choose Format Page Numbers, correct the page number format. It's already restarting at 1 at the new section, and then click OK. So now my document has 3 sections. The first section has no numbering. The second one has lowercase Roman numeral page numbers. And the third one has Arabic numbers. Each section starts its page numbering back at 1. By the way, this is a trick that'll serve you in good stead in other situations. For instance, ever have one of those long agreements where everybody gets their own signature page because they've got to execute the agreement in subparts and send the pages back? And of course, somebody, I won't name any names, wants each signature page to have its own customized header. Well, the next time you're asked, "Can we do that?" you can answer confidently, "Yes, we can." Where have I heard that phrase before? Hey, if this video has helped you, be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any new videos in this series. And if you're in the middle of writing a brief, you're probably including a table of authorities, which can be a bona fide minefield. Let me help. Download my free Table of Authorities pre-published checklist, which shows you the 10 most common problems you'll run into with TOA, with links to helpful articles and videos on how to fix them. To make sure yours is up to standards before you print or PDF your next brief, click on the link above or in the description below and download your free checklist today.